Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market, your weekly look at the Amal Market. I still haven't really fully get rid of my cold, so it probably still sounds a little bit different, but nothing to do about it. But hey, we're still gonna do the video, doesn't matter. An announcement of CCP this week that they're gonna do particle free to play Eve Online. Very simple set. You can play EVE Online for free, but you're gonna have a limit to it. They call it clone stats. You have the normal clone, then it's like you can only train skills from the race you select in the beginning, and then you can have like up to about 5 million skill points max. So you can fly frigates, destroyers, I think also cruisers. That's about the limit then what you can fly. But if you want to get further in the game, you have to get a subscription for if you need to pay for it, or use Plex for it. And then you can do everything in EVE. That's something what they're gonna that they're planning to implement. I wonder what you guys think of this. I think they have definitely an opportunity to get more players in the game, but and easier for people to try it out. But yeah. If they're really gonna get more players eventually, I'm not so sure. But we'll see what that's gonna do. Let me know what you guys think of it. It's gonna be interesting to see what you all think of that. But we're here for the market. Let's go straight away for Tritanium. I still have a little bit of a cold, so now and then maybe shut up a little bit. So. Like that. So, Tritanium is still. Looks. Definitely, if I look at the 20-day average, it is slightly going up, crossing the 4.60x per unit. Yeah, today is sitting slightly lower. But on the 20-day average, we clearly see small uptrend in price. It's not going really too quick, but it is going up. The 5-day is having it's up towards the here 580 almost, then drop back down again towards the 540 even. Going back up just above the 560 and then dropping again. It's going up and down, but on average, it's on the 20-day average, we're slightly going up in price for Tritanium. As expected, because we're heading the end for the summer. For the sellers, 5.63, there's a whole bunch of 5 million amounts here on the market. They really put up the market pretty close together, so it's probably one guy. So, sellers, 5.63, buyers, 5.54. It's yeah, it went only really slightly up. 5.51 was last week's price, so even then it's not really doing a lot. It says on the graph at least 20 average, but we're going up pretty a lot. It is on the buy side, it's going really really slow. This was last week's price, 5.50. So it's not really moving. These two can get filled pretty quick. We may even see pretty soon a drop in price of that. So, then, ferrite. Ferrite is still doing pretty stable, even all 20-day average is showing that it's starting to drop in price. Still 5 days now, and then going up and then going back down. We did hit here the Friday, almost again the 9 is per unit. Then straight away the Saturday went back up above the 9.5. That's pretty high here, and even almost towards the 10 is per unit a few times ago this month. Definitely it's trying to go up, but it doesn't want to go up because it's like a few days high and then suddenly drops back down again, heading towards the 9A. So it wants to go up, but it's not going up. That's what is why I think maybe see maybe a drop in it. Not too many buyers, by the way. 9.65 for the sellers. For the buyers, 9 is still exactly the same price as last week. So no change to ferrite price, exactly the same at all. Last week was also 9 ISK, so still this can get filled pretty quickly, and then we're gonna drop down towards the 894, and then we're gonna have record bottom prices again for ferrite. But for now, that has not happened. Maxilon, still on the drop, but we see here for the Saturday and the Sunday, we're sitting on a higher price for Maxilon. It has been going down for a pretty decent time. for at least about 3 months, it starts slowing down slightly there, and then suddenly making a little bit quicker drop in price. We can clearly see here Saturday, Sunday, suddenly a higher price. We can also see here, this is also about the weekend, it has higher prices. So it's maybe just a weekend high price, and then it's gonna drop back down again, maybe. But it also can say that nope, we're gonna keep going up. It's not really clear. There has been a little bit bigger sales on these days here. It could have influenced on the price a little bit, that's pushing the price up. But not really sure about it. It's really unclear what this is gonna do. For the sellers, 64.96 on that. For the buyers, 58.08. It is a lower price. Last week's price was 58.59. So we have a small drop still here on the price on Maxelon. If this is gonna keep on going on next week, maybe. Depending if this is only a weekend thing, this jumps up. And then it's going back down. It's possible, but yeah, it's really unclear what it's gonna do. Oxygen, on the other hand, has been pretty stable for the whole week on average prices. Not really a huge amount of movement in here. Even the 5-day has been really stable on this. Not moving a lot. 20 days just trying to get back up on the 5-day average. But also here on the Saturday, Sunday, you see suddenly an increase in price a little bit for oxygen. Could be a temporary one, but it has been already going up for like 2 weeks slightly, the price of oxygen. And this is it looks like here we had a really really low price. It's been the lowest it's ever gonna get, so I think this point there was definitely the lowest price of oxygen, and we're definitely gonna see now more of an uptrend in the winter on the price of oxygen. I'm pretty sure about that. Especially with this new thing coming in, free to play, players may mine more minerals coming to the market, or players gonna buy more minerals and pushing the price up. Everything can happen. 81.05 for the sellers and 76.91 for the buyers. And that's a lower price than last week. 77.35 was last week's price. Oxygen is on the buy side still dropping. Size of orders, not the big ones here. If we keep these fulfilled, heading towards this one, we're getting close towards new bottom price records again for it. So it's a lower price than last week. This one gets fulfilled, we're gonna see a quick drop to the 74 on the oxygen. If these get fulfilled, we're gonna go back to 73, and then that's a small one, it can go back to 71. If we hit the 71, it's gonna be definitely bottom record prices for oxygen. So we see a lot of prices that are really really low at the moment. It's heading the end for the summer and people starting to come back. Then we have Noxygen, hasn't been done really this much this week. It's very slowly crawling up in price, as you can see. The average price was like all the time below the 5 and 20 day average, but now here we see at the end for the Saturday and Sunday again, we see only the average price is above both lines, so we're gonna see an increase in price here. Also here we had a big drop here in price, really low price, 385 Noxygen here. Definitely starting to go back up. We may see this price just going back up towards the 440 around that price, or maybe even higher, because we're heading towards the winter and people coming back. So that's what probably Noxium is gonna do. It has been pretty well, not a lot of movement the whole week, but only a very slight movement in price. For the sellers, 415.88. For the buyers, 396.30. On the buyer's price, that is slightly higher than last week. 394 was last week's price, so I've seen a very small increase in price for Noxygen. Oh crap, on that. So we're going back up, we're just not reaching the record price, record bottom price. If it's gonna go down, a little bit more, then we have a chance to hit a new record bottom price. But it's just going up now, and we're probably not going to see a record on that. But Noxium going up, also expecting this one to keep on going up next week, like most of the minerals. Then we have Zynerit. Well done. Zynerit, no movement at all. It's very, very flat line for the whole week. We see a small dip there. It's there's no movement in it at all. This whole month has been pretty quiet. Yeah, beginning of the month on this one, it's had a little bit of movement, but very, very stable on price. Not a lot of movement. So it looks Zynerit at the moment has found a very, very stable spot on the prices. that's a pretty low price for the sellers. 1035.50. It's a pretty low price on the sellers, but it's not a huge amount, only 50,000 units. And for the buyers, we're sitting at 1032.69. It is a lower price still, pretty a lot lower than last week. Last week's price was 1117.26, so still the buyers' price has dropped pretty a lot, but that's not visible in the whole graph here. The graph says still pretty much sitting out at the same price. But I look clearly at the data of it, the buyer's price is dropping. So that's surprisingly, that's we see here at least there a difference in the price. But we're not gonna get ever close to the record prices of that. Then we have Megasite. Let's see what Megasite is doing. Also, pretty much the whole week, very stable on price, no movement at all. Only one day here dropped slightly lower on price. For day, we're sitting slightly low, still early day. But also here, very, very stable on price, not a lot of movement in this. We can see maybe effect for both, for Zynomax, I may be seeing next week. It's going to move again, but yeah, which way? I don't know. Can go up, can go down. For the sellers, 1329, well, 1330 for the sellers, 1270.09 for the buyers. That has gone up to a bit. 1250.57 was last week's price, so it's a small increase in price on the mega site, but also not too much. One more mineral, that's Morphite. Morphite has been sitting still pretty much in the same region of price. Seems to want to go lower, wants to drop in price. Once the drop looks like in price, we're starting to drop a little bit below the 10,000 here. Can also see the ranges where it's sitting in on the high side is slightly dropping. So we can also see here, 20 day and 5 day average are moving rapidly around, but you can clearly see that the points are high, but it's dropping again, but it's not going to get up that much more higher. So we see very slowly. For sure, Morphite is dropping in price. We see here and then spikes on sales. It's probably also maybe pushing the price down on Morphite. Still not many buyers. 11,243 for the sellers. And for the buyers, 9,805. That is a drop in price, not too much. 9,840 was last week's price, so it is dropped slightly. So like clearly see here, then it's very, very slowly dropping in price. So after the huge spikes we had here on price, suddenly we see a huge amount of sales and spiked up rapidly on price. Then it dropped really, really quickly again. People start buying in again because the price was still high for where it came from. And went back up again. Now it dropped again after that. It has movement between certain regions, but it's very slowly looks to be dropping. At least, well, if I look on this graph here, if you look at the 5-day and can pull a line on this, it's very slightly going up, at least the 20-day average. But the data says slightly different. But we'll see next week what this is going to do. I have a feeling it's trying to drop on price at least. Then we're going to look at some regular salvage in this region, in the domain region. Armor plates did went very, very low. A week ago it was about pretty low. Lowest it got 50,000. Here was even one lower, but about 47,000. That's a really, really low price for armor plates. But now we see a rapid moving up in price, heading toward the 56,000 per unit again. This will definitely going to keep on going on the next week, because it did make suddenly a huge drop in price. It's been dropping for a pretty long time. It came like from 95 to almost 100,000 per unit. Been dropping for such a long time. I think it's a really good time to buy in armor plates too at the moment, because it is low and this definitely will not going to go up for a long time, because it is so low. For the sellers, there's hardly one any above 500. That's only here 60,000 per unit for the sellers. That's more than 500 units. And for the buyers, 55,600 on the buyers. Definitely starting to go up. 55,000 flat was last week's price, so it went up with 600 isk a unit. And I'm definitely going to see more of an uptrend in price for this, because it is so low now. It is already starting to go up. Sorry. I say it's a really, really good opportunity now to buy armor plates. Burn logic circuits. Still going up. Did go up pretty rapidly this week, coming from the 55,000 towards the 60,000. So there's a 2,000 isk increase suddenly here in price. Expecting what this one is going to do is not really clear. Look at the big graph. Expecting more to starting to go up more and more. This was being put on the low side. Starting to go up still. Also expecting this one next week to still go up in price. Not too many sellers, but also not too many buyers. Well, if I go for more than 500 units, I'm going to drop all the way to about 100,000 per unit for burn logic circuits. That's really, really expensive for burn logic circuits. But if you look at the lowest one, is 59,811 on the lower side. But I'm always going more than 500 units, and then we get pretty high on price. So basically, there are not too many burn logic circuits on the market. After the 1,000 one, we're getting a little bit more bigger ones on the market. Also for the buyers, not too many buyers, so this really can go both ways. It looks like most people are trying to buy it off the market at the moment. That's pushing the price up. For the buyers, we're sitting at 59,700. Still the higher price than last week's week. 58,000 was last week's price, so we went pretty rapidly up in price. I'm definitely going to expect this price to go up more on the upcoming week. Fried interface circuits also was a little bit low here. It's not doing too much. Let's see, last week's price was sitting around there. That was about last week's price here, 2,300. Starting to move a little bit up to the 2,400. Huge sales, by the way, yesterday. High and low is about the same yesterday. So look at the amount being sold yesterday. Huge amount being sold. Today 504 is the lowest at the moment. But that's surprising, the amount of sales. And if you look at the effect on the market for today, it was yesterday. It can come a little bit later, can come tomorrow. That's going to be shown, or the day after that on Tuesday. But there's not a lot of movement, even this big sales. There's maybe someone that put up a really huge order up for the same price and get fulfilled. But this had no effect at the moment on the market. You see a slight uptrend today, but that's about it. Copy this order. For the seller's price, 2,887 for the sellers. For the buyers, sitting at 2,000 flat on that. That's lower than last week's. 2,300 was last week's price, so it has dropped another 300. And this is a big order. If this one gets fulfilled, we're gonna drop quite rapidly on price here. So we can go pretty quickly lower if this one gets fulfilled, but it is a big one. Take a look at multi-capacitor consoles. It's trying to drop again. It's going to get lower. We're heading towards the 4,000 per unit again. We're going to head towards slowly towards a normal price for this. But still, it's like double off the way where it came from. Went lower here to about 4,000, but straight away next day we're coughed again to 5,000. And almost went to 5,500 with the up. When you see from where it's coming from, where we used to came from was about 8,000 or 8,500. We're sitting a lot lower here already for 6,000 to 6,500. See a drop again, and it's never gonna recover back up again. So it keeps dropping and dropping. Eventually, I think we're gonna get towards the 2,000, maybe 3,000 mark, and that's gonna be more of a stable price for multi-capacitor consoles. But we see a slight uptrend here. But that's only for a moment. I think definitely gonna go back down further on the next week. Sellers, there's not too huge amount of on the market in the beginning, because it's gonna get rapidly up to 6,600 per unit for the sellers. Well, on the buyers, we have hardly anyone buying it. 5,250 for the buyers. Slightly lower, 5,300 was last week's price. So it has gone down slightly, but not too much. Gets fulfilled, we're gonna drop to 4,000. So yeah, it can go down pretty rapidly when we need to. Then trip power circuits did make a pretty drop on the last week, but you can clearly see bigger sales here. It's starting to recover straight away again. Heading back up to the 13,000 or even higher, heading towards the 13,500 here even for today. So it was just a temporary drop. If you bought in, like someone bought in here a huge amount, maybe are you gonna put it on the market or maybe hold on for a little bit longer, because you can see still an uptrend here on a Sunday. You may can get a pretty good profit out of it. I think it's maybe gonna go up more. It has going ups and downs for pretty long time. Yeah, we are still pretty low on price. This is pretty big up. You see, we had one here, a big up in price. We have them more often, but you still, it doesn't want to go up to the 32,000 per unit. It's still dropping. This is maybe just a small up again. And then we're just gonna see another drop towards maybe towards the 10,000 per unit. I'm expecting this one's definitely to start dropping more in price, because it's been going on for such a long time. Still, not too many sellers on the market. Still, 15,999 for the sellers. For the buyers, sitting at 13,400. That's higher than last week at least. Last week's price was 13,000 flat. So it did went up slightly in price on this. But I'm expecting this to, the buyer's price starting to go up. But I think if people hold off a little bit more, we may can get a price more towards the 10,000 of this. Then, Plex can have a big effect on this, of the new announcement. Doesn't really seem to have any effect. We did went pretty high up here, about in the middle of the week. To about 1,445,000,000 for a Plex, looks like it. It's around the middle there. After that, we're seeing again a drop in the Plex price. Yesterday, the Saturday, we're sitting just below the 1,010,000,000 is for a Plex. For today, we're going a little bit back up to 1,020,000,000 for a Plex. If this thing is gonna happen, this thing comes out, and people gonna like Eve and have enough money for Plex, we may see an increase in price of Plex. But on the other hand, people don't have really a lot of ISK at that moment. So there's a chance of there's going to be a lot more plexus coming towards the market for people that want to make some quick ISK to do stuff in ETH. So that's also a chance. So it can go, maybe both, it can go up, it can go down if this new patch comes out with free to play. But it can also stay pretty stable, because we're going to have both things. But most of the new characters probably cannot. Of course, if the really new people coming towards the game, they cannot pay for this. But if people are going to create more alts, if people have like really a lot of money on their main, they're going to plex those new alts of them, then we're going to see an increase in plex price again. So I think the last one has a bigger chance that's going to happen. That plex price is going to increase. The chance is bigger, but if it's going to happen, I don't know. That's the next thing. That's what we're going to see when it's coming out. Plex price is currently 1 billion, about 61 million for the sellers. For the buyers, we're sitting below the 1 billion here again. 998.1 million for a plex for the buyers. I really like this. Let's see, it's dropped below the 1 billion again. Really like that. It's good. Last week's price was still 1 million for a plex. So really good to see that we see this drop in plex. But yeah, let me know what you think about this new thing that's coming out on the patch, free to play for EVE Online. What do you think about this? CCP is doing? What you think, is the game dying because they're suddenly turning this way, or not? Hopefully this is going to bring this more life back into the game. Also, I really wonder what this is going to be effect on the plex price for this, because it can go really both ways. Then can go up, can go down. People want money, or a lot of alts get greater and then the plex price going up. So really not sure what that's going to have for an effect on plex. At least, thanks for watching on this week on the market. We see you all next week again. We're going to take a look at the Remar market. So thanks for watching and fly safe.